Fairfield Christian Church is a Great Commission church, and that's who we are, that's who we'll continue to be, and we believe that we should be in the business of changing lives. And that has no money, it has no schedule, it's just you're always doing that. You know, whatever we do should be there to change lives. If we're not changing lives, then you're not effective. We will be an effective church, so by extension, we will be changing lives. That's who we are, that's our DNA, that's who God called us to be. And again, there's no excuses not to be there.
If you feel a tug on your heart, then you know that's Him telling you, hey, you need to do this, and you will be blessed more than the people that you are trying to bless.
If somebody's belly is empty and they're hurting, they're not going to hear the love of the Lord until their belly is full. And I think that we need to move in that direction.
It's very humbling, you know. You know, what little bit of time I can spend with my girls is, you know, so much more than a dad over there could probably do. And it sounded like sometimes dad's not always around, so I feel like you know, I need to do more for my girls.
They have to experience a lot of stuff, and nobody would want to. I wouldn't want to experience that. They have a hard life, and I want to try to make it better.
And it will impact the life of a young child for him.
Blessed we are in America, and how we can reach out to someone else that's not as blessed as we are. We are to do that as God's people.
I believe we're called to reach out to these people. They are our brothers and sisters in Christ. I mean, it's our responsibility to help them as we can, and especially with these young children, you're not only reaching out to them, you're reaching out to their family, and it was very touching to hear that you are part of their family. As a mother of two young boys, if that was me in a situation, it would mean the world to me. And just knowing that makes me want to do the same for them.
Hearing Julian's story and to walk through her life, I felt connected to the world, not just where we live in Lancaster, Ohio. So we want to be a part of that. We want to help see a child grow up with the hope of God, all that He has for that child. So we are thankful for that compassion.
We're supposed to be like fishers of men and go and get more people to learn about Him. So like when it's the day that He comes, more and more people that can go to heaven.
Causes you to think about your own story. And when I think about the story of my life and how I was privileged to live in a home, were we wealthy? No, we were not wealthy. But did we have more than 90% of the world? Probably we did. And the advantages of that. And so I'm grateful for this opportunity to see the story of people of disadvantage and maybe being able to give them an opportunity to change their lives, not materially, spiritually, to come to know Jesus.